I'm a bird. Like a seagull.
Hank was really impressed with that.
Hey guys,
Nicole here.
Collet Bear, the sass meister. My husband, behind the camera. I'm coming at you with a super cool video called 6 Things I Do Every Day. Nope. 6 Things I Do to Lose Belly Fat and Reduce Bloating. Number one, I drink a lot of water. I drink a little over 5 liters a day, which is the equivalent of just over 2 of these jugs and another bottle and a half about of water a day.
See, she's not lying, it's empty.
Being hydrated helps with digestion and keeping you regular. When you're regular and you have great digestion, you're less bloated. What happens if you're not hydrated? Your body sends out signals saying it's hungry. So you end up turning to food and you're more likely to overeat, which then can lead to weight gain, which can lead to more belly fat. The other thing that it can do is it helps keep you full. It also makes you full faster when you drink it while you are eating your meals.
And while you're dieting, especially for the first time, you want to feel fuller longer. Drink your water.
Drink your water. Being hydrated does so many things for you, including having a flat belly. Second thing that I do, I drink apple cider vinegar every single day. The one that I drink, I only drink the organic raw one with the mother. The mother is that cloudy stuff that you see at the bottom. I drink 1 tablespoon diluted in 4 ounces of water and I drink it through a straw. The reason is apple cider vinegar can be really tough on the enamel on your teeth. So diluting it in water and drinking it through a straw protects your teeth. What apple cider vinegar does, I find it really helps with digestion. And again, when your digestive system is working properly, you are less bloated, your stomach is flatter. Studies have shown that it can help with your resting blood sugar levels. It can help with insulin sensitivity.
Yeah, and you guys, you can look this stuff up. This is not like woo-woo stuff. They've done actual scientific studies on apple cider vinegar. Mm-hmm. It lowers your resting blood sugar. That directly leads to body fat and belly fat. It helps with your insulin sensitivity, and that directly affects your storage of fat on your body.
Yes, Kyle and I both have, like, I don't know how you say that, high insulin insensitivity, or what? We hold more belly fat because we're really sensitive.
We're carb sensitive. Let's say it in a simple way. We're carb sensitive.
That's what we call it. Or sometimes I call it insulin resistant. I don't think that's a proper term, but that's what we say. So we find that the apple cider vinegar really helps with us. We feel flatter, less bloated, leaner when we drink that every day. We drink it at the end of the day too, after our last meal, if you're interested in knowing that. The third thing that I do fasted cardio 6 days a week, and I do weight training, or I lift weights, 4 times a week. Fasted cardio has been said to help you burn more fat, because what you do is you do cardio first thing in the morning on an empty stomach. And why it's supposed to burn more fat is because your body has already gone through all the carb stores. So now when you're doing your cardio, all it has are fat stores left to burn. So that's why it's said to burn more fat, which then would lead to burning more belly fat.
Yeah, and as long as you're not eating a whole bunch right before you go to bed, you should be in a fasted state when you wake up. And that's when we do our cardio. We find we get the best results doing it in a fasted state.
Yes, and the only day we don't do cardio is leg day, because we found Doing it on leg day ruins your muscle building for your legs, which is going to lead into lifting weights 4 times a week. I lift weights to build muscle. Having more muscle means you have less fat. The more muscle you have, the less fat you have. And you cannot spot train, so you have to build muscle on your entire body in order to have less fat everywhere. So if you build muscle everywhere, your belly will get flatter too as the fat burns over your entire body.
Muscle also eats, the more muscle you have, it actually eats calories all day long.
Yeah.
Where cardio doesn't. Cardio just lasts for the 10, 15, 20 minutes you're doing it. Building muscles, eating and using energy all day, even when you're sleeping.
Yep. So let's move on to number 4. Number 4 is something that I'm still working on, which is to lower my cortisol levels.
This is a big one that we don't hear many people talking about, and it's so, so important.
Yes, because the more, or not the more, the higher your cortisol levels are in your body, the more it holds on to body fat. So what that means is if you're really stressed out and you're not getting enough sleep, your body is gonna hold on to more cortisol, which means you generally will carry more belly fat. So trying to sleep better, get better quality sleep, not necessarily more, but better quality sleep, and doing things like meditating or deep breathing before going to bed will help you, you know, get a better, it helps me get a better sleep. Also, working on letting go of stress through meditation and breathing, those all help with sleep and less stress.
Also, going back to cortisol and stress levels, so if your stress levels and cortisol levels are high, that directly relates to belly fat specifically.
Yeah.
Because when the body's in a state of panic, it holds on to stomach fat. So you do, alongside your eating, your diet, and your workouts, you want to deal with the stress part. It really does affect your stomach.
Yeah, we were talking about that off camera, saying like everyone focuses on the diet and the exercise. And yes, diet's most important. Exercise too is next. However, if you don't deal with your stress, if you have a great diet and you exercise, like Kyle and I, both of those are on point all the time. However, if we're really stressed out, we're still gonna be holding on to belly fat. So we're really working on reducing our stress levels and working on sleeping better, because both of us have difficulty sleeping because we have anxiety.
And that's a good point to bring up. Everything on this list will not matter if your diet, stress, and workouts aren't on point. Like the apple cider vinegar, it won't matter.
No.
The cold showers won't matter. Diet is king. Everything else follows after diet.
Yep. And again, you can have an amazing diet and you can work out every day, but if you're stressed, you're still gonna be holding on to the belly fat. So all three gotta be tied up in a nice leety bow.
Leety?
Leety. That means little in Nicole speak.
Got it.
Number 5, never skip meals, especially breakfast. What I found is if I skipped meals or if I didn't eat breakfast, I was more likely to reach for food and overeat at night, which of course leads to feeling bloated that night and the next day, which can also, overeating every single day can lead to weight gain, which means probably more belly fat.
And then your fasted cardio won't actually be fasted because you have a belly full from all the food you ate the night before.
Exactly. The other thing that I want to include in there is I eat every 2 to 4 hours. Spreading my meals out helps keep my metabolism revving and keeps my blood sugar levels even. You want to be hungry for your next meal. You want your metabolism to be working. We hear a lot of people say, well, I can never eat that much food. I'm not hungry. We weren't in the beginning either. We had to retrain our metabolism. What happens is you can damage your metabolism and then it doesn't give you hunger cues anymore. you just never feel hungry, which means your body's not working properly and you're probably holding on to more belly fat.
Yeah, guys, we've been there too, where we didn't want to eat breakfast. We weren't hungry, but all of a sudden late at night, we could eat thousands and thousands of calories late at night. And so many people that we talk to,
do that.
One of the first things they say is, I'm not hungry in the morning. That's because, like Nicole is saying, your metabolism is broken.
You have to retrain your body. We had to retrain it. We weren't hungry in the morning either. We had to eat breakfast anyway. And then eventually it came. Now, I could never not eat breakfast. I like me breakfast. All right, number six, the last one is eat flat belly foods. And what I mean by that is we eat a lot of foods that are slow digesting and contain a lot of fiber. So we eat a balanced diet, including treats, but the balance comes from lean protein, lots of veggies, fruits that are higher in fiber and lower in sugar, like berries. We eat a lot of spinach, and we eat some nuts, some healthy fats. Healthy fats in nuts contain fatty acids, which can actually help increase your metabolic rate, which can help burn fat faster. And the slower digesting foods helps you feel satisfied and fuller longer, which means you're not gonna be reaching for food because you're gonna be satisfied and you're gonna feel full. The other thing is it helps with digestion again, which means less bloating, a more regular system. Regular system means less bloating, less belly fat.
Wow, a balanced diet. We apologize that we're bringing up some common sense stuff. We know it's not popular in 2020 to have common sense and balance in your diet. Something that my grandma told me 100 years ago. It's still true, but still not popular.
The other thing I want to mention before we end the video, I forgot to say Greek yogurt. Greek yogurt can help balance the good bacteria in your gut. A happy gut means great digestion, properly working body, which means flatter, leaner, less belly fat dudes.
So we'll put in some pictures now of what Nicole and me used to look like a few years ago. And we'll show you that although we are not fitness models, bodybuilding all-stars, we have reduced our bellies greatly. That's one of the biggest problem areas that we had back in the day, and we've reduced it greatly.
Guys,
pretty flat for the end of the night.
Yeah, let me show these guys.
Whoa,
the muscle and you get the flat stomachs.
Wow.
Now, again, I like Kyle said, we're not fitness models. I don't have a six pack, I have loose skin. I've lost 130 pounds. My stomach is fairly flat and lean considering where I came from. So, and that's because I do all these actions I just told you. So the friends, hope you enjoyed this video. Don't forget.
I like how you timed that. You might not be a bodybuilder, but you got your routine down.
Yes, I do. Don't forget, check us out on Instagram at the Collets. Hit that bell for notifications so you don't miss any more videos.
Yeah, do all the things.
Don't forget to thumbs this up if you didn't already. And subscribe if you didn't already, so that you can be cool, okay? So hope you guys enjoyed this video. Hope it helps you and inspires you to try some stuff that'll help with your program, your fitness journey. And we love you. Thanks for watching. Have a lovely day. Peace out, dudes. Collet's out.
Goodbye. He disappeared. Bye, guys.
Bye. Remember, the friends, that weight loss isn't just about the number on the scale. It's also about here and here. Heart and mindset. Fight through it. You can do it. Don't give up.